今日讀經的經文是在聖經分開三段，第一段呢就在歷代志下第七章十七節，你若在我面前效法你父大衛所行的，遵行我一切所吩咐你的，谨守我的律例典章。第二段是在帖撒羅尼迦前書五章十六至十八節，要常常喜樂，不住的禱告，凡事謝恩，因為這是神在基督耶穌裡向你們所定的旨意。最後一段是在路加福音第十八章一至八節，耶穌設一個比喻，是要人常常禱告，不可灰心，說某城有一個官，不懼怕神，也不尊重世人。那城裡有個寡婦，常到他那裡說，我有一個對頭，求你給我伸冤。他多日不准，後來心裡說，我雖不懼怕神，也不尊重世人，只因這寡婦煩擾我，我就給他伸冤吧，免得他常來纏磨我。主說，你們聽這不義之官所說的話，神的選民晝夜呼籲他，他縱然為他們忍了多時，豈不終究給他們伸冤麼？我告訴你們，要快快的給他們伸冤了。然而人子來的時候，遇得見世上有信得麼？聖經一段讀畢。
兄弟姊妹平安，
弟兄姊妹早晨。
On the first Sunday of each month, I have the privilege and honor to preach God's word here in the Cantonese service.
在每個月的第一個主日咧，我都好榮幸可以喺我哋粵語堂嗰度咧向大家證道。
Can you believe it's already June? It's the sixth month of the year, and this is the sixth sermon on our church theme, becoming a praying church.
其實我們都不知不覺之間，我們已經去到六月份了。今天也是第六次我們講道的主題是有關，我們希望今年我們的教會成為一間禱告的教會。
I want to thank Pastor HL for translating for me today.
今天我很開心可以幫 Pastor Alan 去翻譯。
God has called us to be a praying church.
神呼召我們今年要成為一間禱告的教會。
We believe as people who are called by God to do this, we have a sacred responsibility to make sure prayer is our most important ministry.
我們相信我們都是被神所呼召的人，我們最神聖的責任就是要確保禱告成為我們最重要的事工。
And if we are serious about praying, we must learn to be more humble in order for our prayers to be accepted by God.
如果我哋认真咁样去祈祷咧，其实我哋必须要学会咧就系谦卑，因为咁样咧我哋嘅祷告先至会被神所接纳嘅。
And when we pray, we must seek God's face, which means we must seek first God's kingdom and righteousness.
当我哋祈祷嘅时候，其实我哋系寻求神嘅面，呢个意思就系话我哋必须要寻求神嘅国度同埋神嘅公义。
Moreover, when we pray, we must turn from our wicked ways. Why would a holy God listen to us pray when we are unwilling to change from our sinful ways?
除此之外，我哋祈祷嘅时候咧，我哋都必须要远离我哋自己嘅恶行。如果我哋唔愿意改过自身嘅话，圣洁嘅上帝又点会听我哋嘅祈祷咧？
This morning, we want to consider a new question concerning prayer. How long should we pray?
在今个早晨我们就会思想一个关于祈祷的新问题，就是说我们应该要祷告多久呢？
Because if you have been seeking God's face, you've been humble, you've turned from your wicked ways, and you still don't hear from God, how long should you pray?
當我哋咧願意係謙卑喺神面前，我哋亦都願意去轉離我哋嘅惡行，我哋都會再問一個問題：咁我哋要祈禱祈幾耐咧
？Did you know that there are two kinds of divine promises in the Bible? There are conditional promises and there are unconditional promises.
大家知唔知道喺聖經入邊咧，神嘅應許咧，其實有兩種嘅，一種咧就係有條件嘅應許，另外一種咧就係無條件嘅應許。
For example, in 1 John 4:9-10, the Bible says, "This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him. This is love, not that we love God, but He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins."
在無條件的應許那一段，其實呢，我們在約翰一書4:9-10，我們就知道那個這樣的意思，就是神差遣祂的獨生子來到這個世界呢，是叫我們得著這個永生。神愛我們的心在這裡就顯明了，不是我們愛神，乃是神愛我們，所以神祂差祂的兒子，為了我們的罪呢，就做了這個挽回祭，這個就是愛。
So, did the world do anything special for God to send Jesus?No, it was unconditional. God sent Jesus into the world, not because we deserve, but because He unconditionally loved the world.
即係當神咧，佢無條件差遣佢嘅兒子降生喺呢個世界上邊去救我哋嘅時候，其實我哋同我哋呢個世界並冇做任何嘢咧，係配得上耶穌嘅嚟到嘅。所以呢個就係神無條件嘅應許。
Another unconditional promise is Jesus said,Peace, my peace I leave with you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not be afraid. When Jesus gives us His peace, it's unconditional.
另外一個無條件嘅應許就係好似約翰福音14:24-27咁樣講。耶穌話：我留下平安俾你哋，我將平安賜俾你哋。我所賜嘅唔係世人所賜，你哋心入邊唔使憂愁，亦都唔需要膽怯。耶穌賜門徒嘅平安，然後就係讓門徒唔需要做任何嘢，亦都可以得著主所賜嘅平安。
So some promises that God gives us are unconditional. You don't have to do anything. God gives it to you.
所以咧，神有一啲無條件嘅應許咧，係我哋唔需要做任何嘢，神都會賜俾我哋嘅。
On the other hand, there are some unconditional promises.
在另外一方面呢，有一些应许呢是有条件的。
My mistake. Conditional promises. Yeah. For example, James chapter 1, verse 5 to 7. The scriptures tell us that if we ask for wisdom from God, we must ask without doubting. That's the condition. If you ask with doubt, then you won't get it.
在雅各書咧1:5-7咧，就係講到一個就係有條件嘅應許。聖經點樣講啊？就話如果我哋向神咧去祈求智慧咧，我哋同時咧係需要唔懷疑神，咁樣神先至會咧慷慨賜俾我哋智慧。所以咧，我哋需要咧唔懷疑神，咁然後我哋先得著神嘅智慧。
So maybe you've been praying for wisdom, but in your heart you don't think you will get it. That's why you don't get it.
咁所以咧，如果我哋去祈禱，我哋係去祈求神俾我哋智慧，但我哋懷疑佢嘅時候，咁我哋就唔會得著神嘅應許。
Matthew 6:33, Jesus promised that if we seek first God's kingdom and righteousness, then everything will that you need will be given as well. You have to seek God first. That's the condition.
在馬太福音第6:32-33，耶穌的應許就說，如果我們先求神的國和神的義，然後我們所需要的一切都會得到供應。所以前提就是說，我們一定要先求神的國和神的義。
This is a picture of Moses and the people of Israel. And Moses, being given God's word, declared this conditional promise to the people of Israel.
在摩西的時代，神就向以色列人就提了一個選擇。摩西去告訴他們聽，就說神要以色列人遵行一些這樣的律法之後，才可以得著神的祝福。
So God gave the people of Israel a choice. If you obey God's laws, then you will be blessed. If you don't obey, then you will be cursed.
所以神就向以色列人咧，佢咧就提出咗一个选择：如果你哋遵行我嘅律法，咁样你哋就得着祝福；如果你哋唔遵守嘅话咧，咁你哋就会得到唔服从嘅后果。
So I'm going to ask Pastor HL to read Deuteronomy chapter 28, just a few verses to show you that God was giving the people of Israel a conditional promise.
在《申命記》28章1至10節這一段經文裡面，其實呢，摩西向以色列人所講就是說神的祝福是帶有條件的。經文怎樣講呢？就說在28章1節，你們若留意聽從耶和華你的神的話，谨守遵行他一切的诫命，就是我今天所吩咐你的，他必使你超乎天下万民之上。然后在第二节就说，你若听从神的话，以下的福呢必跟随住你，亦都临到你的身上。你在城里面必蒙福，在田里又是必蒙福，你出也蒙福，入也蒙福。这个就是有一个前提，就是我们要听神的说话，这些福气就会跟着我们。
However, if you do not obey, and so beginning from verse 15 all the way to 64, if you don't obey, then you will receive the consequence of your disobedience.
在《申命記》，我哋跟住落去喺第十五節嗰度咧，就講到如果我哋唔聽從，咁會得到咩後果咧？十五節講到話，你若不聽從耶和華你神的話，不緊守遵行佢一切嘅戒命同埋律例，就係我今日所吩咐你嘅。你就有以下的咒诅都会跟随住你，亦都是临到你的身上。那有什么咒诅呢？就说你在城里面必受到咒诅，在田里也必受到咒诅，你出也受咒诅，入也受咒诅。
Do you get the idea?
大家明不明白当中的道理呢？
For conditional promises, the Lord will do exactly what he has promised, but we must satisfy all the requirements God has set.
就是对于神有条件的应许，神会按照祂的应许去做，但是我们必须要是满足神所提出的要求。
So what do you think about this promise? Is this conditional or unconditional?
当我们今年的年度主题是历代志下的七章十四节，大家觉得这一段经文究竟是神无条件呢，还是有条件的应许呢？
What do you think?
大家觉得呢？
Conditional.
是啦，是有条件的。
If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins and heal their land.
没错啦，在七章十四节这个大条件的应许，神说，这称为我名下的子民，若是自卑祷告，寻求我的面，转离他们的恶行，我就必从天上垂听，赦免他们的罪，亦都是医治他们的地。
But what happens if you think, I have sought God's face, I have turned from my wicked ways, I have prayed, but I haven't heard from God? How long shall I pray?
大家有没有试过，就是说我们已经寻求神的面，我们亦都转离我们自己的恶行，但是我们的祈祷很久都没有得到神的回应。
Perhaps you've been praying for someone to come to know Jesus, but after many, many years, they still don't believe.
大家有没有试过呢，就是为一个人去祈祷，他认识了耶稣，但是很多年之后呢，他都好像离开主很远，没有追求认识更深有关耶稣的事。
Perhaps you have prayed for a personal problem to be resolved, but after many, many months of praying, there's still no solution.
又或者大家有没有试过，就是为着自己可能遇到一些问题去祈祷，但是你祈好耐祷，这些问题依然存在，亦都没办法去解决呢？
Perhaps like the Apostle Paul, you have a thorn in your flesh, and you have prayed for God to take it away, but still the pain remains.
又或者我们好像保罗这样，我们的生命里面有一条刺，我们很想神帮我们拿走它，但是呢，去到目前为止，这一条刺和它所带来的痛苦依然这样跟随着我们。
Or maybe perhaps you've struggled with an area in your life of sinfulness, and you pray and pray, and still you cannot overcome this sin.
又或者呢，你经常犯某一种罪，你为到你所犯的罪一次又一次这样向神去祈祷，但是你每一次每一次都在这个罪上跌倒。
So how long should you pray?
咁樣我哋究竟應該要堅持同樣嘅禱告幾耐呢？
So here are three biblical insights to help us understand what God is doing, so that we can continue to persevere in prayer.
咁我哋下邊咧就會用三點咧，有三點嘅提示咧，希望可以幫助我哋理解咧神喺度做緊啲乜嘢嘢。希望咧下邊呢三個提示咧可以幫助我哋咧堅持咁樣去祈禱。
The first insight is prayer is God's command.
第一點咧就係話咧，其實咧禱告咧係神俾我哋嘅命令。
And because it is commanded by God, it is not our place to question the commander. How long should we pray?
因為咧祈禱係神俾我哋嘅命令，所以其實我哋係唔應該去質疑咧俾呢個命令嘅上帝，去問我哋要祈禱祈幾耐啊？
We simply obey. Our commander says pray, and so we pray.
其實我哋只需要服從，因為上帝叫我哋祈禱，咁我哋就唯有順從去祈禱啦。
Our responsibility is to obey the command to pray, not to question how long.
我哋嘅責任就係我哋順服上帝俾我哋嘅命令，我哋唔會去懷疑上帝話我哋究竟要祈禱祈幾耐。
It is God's responsibility to answer our prayer in His time, in His wisdom, in His way.
而上帝佢幾時去回覆我哋，同埋用點樣嘅方法去回應我哋嘅祈禱，呢個就係取決於神啦。
And until God tells us to stop, we don't stop. We keep on praying.
直至到神有一日同我哋講話，好啦，你唔使為呢樣嘢去祈禱嘅時候，我哋先至唔祈禱。如果唔係，我哋就繼續咁樣去祈禱落去。
Scripture tells us in 1 Thessalonians 5:16, Rejoice always, pray continually.
在那個帖撒羅尼加前書的5章16節至17節就說，要常常喜樂，要不住的禱告。
The command is clear. We must pray without ceasing. Occasional prayer is not enough. Praying only during times of crisis is insufficient. We must pray continually.
其實呢一條命令咧非常之清晰同明確嘅，我哋要不斷咁樣去祈禱。我哋間唔中嘅祈禱其實係唔足夠嘅，淨係喺危機喺危險嘅時候去祈禱，亦都係唔足夠嘅。我哋必須要不斷咁樣祈禱，恆切咁樣去祈禱。
The God of the universe desires for us to commune with Him constantly. Therefore, we must not stop praying.
神希望我哋透過祈禱咧，不斷咁樣去同佢交談同埋交流，所以我哋一定要必須不停咁樣去祈禱。
In Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18, Scripture says, "Pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests, and with this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints."
喺以弗所書6:18咧，經文就講到話，靠住聖靈，隨時多方禱告祈求。並要在此警醒不倦，為眾聖徒咧去祈求嘅。
So there's so many people who need prayer. There's so many different situations. We keep on praying.
其實我哋知道有好多人需要我哋嘅祈禱，我哋亦都知道咧喺好多情況之下，我哋係需要禱告嘅。
So firstly, prayer is God's command. We don't stop. We don't ask how long.
咁我哋知道第一點就係話，祈禱就係神嘅命令，我哋就順從，我哋唔會去問我哋要祈幾耐。
Secondly, we continue to persevere in prayer because prayer is God's will for us. We pray until God's purposes are fulfilled.
第二點咧就係話，我哋蒙召咁樣堅持祈禱咧，因為祈禱咧係神對我哋嘅旨意，我哋需要不斷嘅祈禱，直至到神嘅旨意實現。
1 Thessalonians 5:18, Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
在帖撒羅尼加前書的第五章十八節經文就是講到話，凡事謝恩，因為這是神在基督耶穌裡向你們所定的旨意。
God's good and pleasing and perfect will is for us to persevere in prayer. We may not completely understand what God is doing, but prayer is effective and it works.
神嘅信量、神嘅善良、纯全同埋可喜悦嘅旨意，其实就系要我哋咧坚持咁样去祈祷。我哋可能咧冇办法完全睇得清楚神嘅旨意究竟系点样通过我哋嘅祈祷去实现，但系祈祷确实系有作用，亦都系有效噶。
How can we understand God perfectly? We don't understand how He works, but He works.
我哋冇办法明白上帝所做嘅一切，因为我哋都系有限嘅。但系上帝嘅作为就系有效，我哋嘅祈祷就系有效嘅。
Sometimes we don't think God has heard us or answered our prayer, but He has answered our prayer.
好多时候咧，我哋觉得咧神冇听我哋嘅祈祷，但系其实上帝系有听我哋嘅祈祷噶。
The reality is God always answers, but we don't always accept God's answers.
其实咧，喺事实上边咧，其实冇一个祈祷咧系神冇回应嘅。但系问题只不过咧就系话咧，我哋要知道咧，有时神嘅回应咧系我哋唔愿意接受嘅。
So sometimes we're happy when God says yes, I grant you your prayer。
当神咧对我哋嘅祈祷嘅回应系咧，我哋所求嘅都按照我哋自己心目中所想嘅去实现咧，我哋就会非常之开心。
How many of you are happy when God says yes to you?
大家当神去答应你祈祷时候，系咪好开心咧？
Yeah. What about when God says no?
但系当神向我哋嘅祈祷话唔得嘅时候，咁你会点咧？
That's still an answer.
当上帝话我唔应许你嘅祈祷嘅时候，其实呢个都系上帝嘅答案。
God loves us too much.To say yes to our inappropriate requests.
大家有冇谂过？因为神太爱我哋，所以佢先至唔会答应我哋嗰啲唔恰当嘅要求。
When your request does not bring glory to you, does not bring glory to God or Jesus or the church, God says no.
当我哋嘅祈祷，我哋所求嘅，如果冇为上帝带来荣耀，如果冇为耶稣基督同教会带来荣耀嘅话，我哋所祈求嘅，上帝就会讲话。
When your prayer doesn't help you to grow spiritually or become more mature, God says no.
如果我哋嘅祷告咧冇办法帮助我哋喺属灵上边更加成熟同埋成长嘅话咧，上帝依然唔会答应我哋嘅祈祷。
When your request does not produce fruit of the Holy Spirit in you, God says no.
如果我哋嘅祈祷系冇办法令到我哋结出圣灵嘅果子嘅话咧，上帝都唔会答应我哋嘅祈祷噶。
And when your request is not according with God's will, God says no.
如果我哋嘅祈祷同埋神嘅话语、神嘅教导系唔一致嘅话咧，上帝都唔会答应我哋嘅祈祷噶。
Even Jesus had his requests. When Jesus prayed in Gethsemane, God, take this suffering, this cup of suffering from me. God says no.
就连耶稣咧喺一次嘅祷告入边咧，都遇到咧上帝唔答应。嘅情況嘅喺路加福音咧22:42，當耶穌同神講話父啊，你若願意就把這杯撤去吧。喺客西馬利園咧，神對耶穌嘅祈禱咧就係話佢唔答應，唔會攞走呢個苦杯。
Because it was the Father's will that the Son of God suffer at the hands of people and was crucified by them.
因为咧呢个苦杯咧，其实就系父神所交俾耶稣嘅。耶稣就系有呢个苦杯，就系为我哋世人嘅罪咧，走上呢个咁嘅十字架上面，同埋喺十字架上边流血为我哋而死嘅。
So sometimes we pray and we say, Lord, how come you don't answer me? And God says, I did. I said no.
当我哋有阵时我哋去怀疑神啊，神啊，你几时先至听我祈祷？点解你冇回应我嘅祈祷嘅时候，其实上帝已经回应咗，就系话上帝唔答应我哋嘅祈祷。
Sometimes we want to go ahead, but God says not yet.
有阵时咧，我哋祈祷希望咧，我哋可以向前走一步嘅时候咧，但系上帝嘅回复有阵时同我哋讲就话，你先等一阵啦，而家仲未系时候。
You know, children, when you're going on a road trip, they say, "Are we there yet?" And the parents say.No, not yet.
好似我哋有阵时去长途旅行咧，啲细路咧可能就会成日问我哋：爸爸妈妈，我哋到咗未啊？咁我哋咧就会同佢讲话：未啊，仲未到啊。
Or they ask, can we open our Christmas presents early? You say, no, not yet.
又或者咧，啲细路咧，佢哋收到圣诞礼物嘅时候，都未到圣诞节，佢哋就话：可唔可以拆开礼物啊？我哋都会同佢讲话：
Or, I finished practice piano. Can I go now? He says, no, not yet.
又或者我哋学琴嘅时候咧，我哋弹完琴，我哋想走嘅时候咧，我哋爸爸妈妈都同我哋讲话，未啊，仲未走得住。
God delays His. God sometimes delay answering a prayer to serve His purpose.
上帝有陣時咧，去延遲回應我哋嘅祈禱咧，其實係希望，其實係希望佢嘅旨意去成就嘅。佢有佢嘅目的。
Sometimes God delays to answer our prayer to test our faith and our patience in Him.
上帝有陣時咧延遲去回應我哋嘅祈禱，其實都係想咧考驗我哋嘅耐性同埋對佢嘅信心。
So continuing to pray when God says not yet is difficult to do.
即係當我哋知道神唔答應我哋嘅祈禱嘅時候咧，又或者神向我哋講話，哎呀，你再等一等嘅時候，喺呢一種嘅情況之下，如果我哋能夠堅持祈禱咧，其實係更加困難。
Martin Luther once said, "Pray hardest when it is hardest to pray."
馬丁路德咧，佢曾經就講過，堅持祈禱其實就係喺咧最難祈禱嘅時候，仍然要祈禱。
Whichever way God answers us, with a yes or no or not yet, we must humbly accept God's answer.
無論神咧選擇用邊種方式去回應我哋嘅祈禱，無論佢話好啦，我應承你啦，又或者神話我唔答應你嘅祈禱，又或者神要我哋再等一等嘅時候咧，我哋都必須要咧敞開我哋嘅心扉，然後就謙卑咁樣接受神俾我哋嘅回應。
So we persevere in prayer because it is God's command. We persevere in prayer because it is God's will. And finally, we persevere in prayer because prayer is a spiritual discipline.
我哋頭先講到第一點咧，就係話咧，我哋堅持咁樣去禱告咧，因為咧禱告係神嘅命令。然後我哋點解第二點咧，我哋就講到堅持禱告，因為禱告係神對我哋嘅旨意。我哋而家講第三點，就係話咧，我哋堅持禱告，因為禱告係屬靈嘅操練。
God uses the discipline of persevering in prayer to transform us to become more like Jesus.
上帝咧，其實係用緊我哋嘅禱告咧，去訓練我哋咧，變成更加似主耶穌基督嘅樣式。James
chapter 1 verse 3 and 4 says, "Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything."
喺雅各書1:3-4節咧，經文就係講到話咧，因為知道你們的信心越經過試驗，就產生忍耐；但忍耐也當成功，使你們成全完備，毫無缺欠。So
when we pray over and over again and persevere in prayer, God uses this praying to change us.
當我哋咧不斷咁樣唔放棄去祈禱嘅時候，雖然有陣時神唔回應，但我哋就一路不斷咁樣去祈禱嘅時候，神就藉住呢個過程咧，將我哋嘅生命，將我哋本身個個性去改變過嚟，更加符合佢嘅心意，更加似主耶穌基督。
So, for Christians, if you don't feel I've been a Christian for so long and still not mature, perhaps it's because you haven't been transformed through prayer.
當我哋咧做基督徒，可能做咗好長一段時間，但係我哋都覺得自己好似同神離開好遠，自己嘅靈命冇成長嘅時候，可能其中一個原因就係話我哋冇喺禱告入邊去得著神嘅改變。So
Jesus told this parable to the disciples to teach them, to show them that they should always pray and not give up.
耶穌咧就用一個比喻咧，去教導佢嘅門徒咧，講俾佢哋聽咧，要經常咁樣禱告，唔好放棄。It's
a story about this widow who, while being oppressed, she appealed to the judge for justice.
呢個比喻入邊咧講咧，就係有一個寡婦啊，佢咧受到欺壓，咁佢咧就向呢個法官咧去求助，希望呢個法官咧為佢伸張正義。
And the judge, he was not a very kind judge. He didn't care about people. He didn't fear God. And at first, he rejected the widow's request.
咁呢個法官咧，佢咧又唔敬畏神，亦都唔敬畏人啊！咁所以咧，佢咧就都冇理，開頭都冇理呢個寡婦嘅要求。
But day after day, this widow came and bothered this judge.
但係咧，呢個寡婦咧就每一日咧咁樣都去煩住呢個咁嘅法官。
And the judge was so tired. He says, "Okay, I will grant you justice."
直至到有一日咧，呢個法官都頂唔順啦。佢話：好啦，我就幫你去。伸張呢個咁嘅公義咧。
And Jesus said, "Is God like this? No, God is not like this unjust judge."
耶穌其實佢呢個比喻咧，唔係同我哋講話上帝就好似呢個不義嘅法官，唔係。
If this judge can grant the widow's request, how much more do you think God will grant your request?
耶穌喺呢個比喻入邊咧，佢想提到嘅就話。就算呢個咁嘅不義嘅法官，最後都係願意為呢個寡婦去伸冤嘅時候，上帝又點會唔回應我哋嘅祈禱咧
？The point of this parable, according to Jesus, was we need to pray as persistently as that widow pleaded with the judge.
喺呢個比喻入邊咧，其實耶穌想教導就話，我哋要好似呢個比喻入邊嘅寡婦咁樣咧，不斷咁樣堅持去禱告。
So are you willing?For God to use prayer to change you to become more like Jesus.
弟兄姊妹，你愿唔愿意让神咧继续去使用我哋持之以恒不断嘅祷告咧，系改变我哋，令我哋去成长？
Because every prayer that you pray is an opportunity for God to bless you, to shape your character, to deepen your faith, to help you become more trusting in God.
其实每一次嘅祈祷咧，都系神咧喺当中咧祝福紧我哋。佢咧希望我哋嘅品格，希望我哋嘅信仰得着改变，越嚟越像主耶稣基督，更加识得去倚靠佢。
The opposite is to pray and then stop and then quit. You don't get change, nothing gets done.
相反嘅就系话，我哋会唔会有阵时因为祈祷之后，话祈祷之后咁我哋就放弃啦，咁啊算数啦。咁咧其实好多嘢咧，我哋嘅祷告冇得到回应，但系我哋亦都得唔到任何嘅嘢，因为我哋已经放弃咗啦。
Our initial goal in praying may be to get what we want. However, we realize God's goal is to get us.
我哋嘅祈祷咧，最初嘅目的咧，可能咧净系为咗咧想要得到我哋想要嘅嘢。但係咧，我哋慢慢我哋會意識到咧，上帝嘅目的咧，其實咧，神最想得著我哋呢一個人。
God's goal is to get us to know Him better, to trust Him more, to obey Him more completely, to love Him more deeply.
神要得著我哋呢一個人嘅意思就係咩咧？就係讓我哋呢一個人咧，讓我哋更加去了解佢、信任佢、更加去順服佢，最重要係更加去愛佢。
So we realize at the end.Prayer is not about getting from God.
其实我哋咧最后咧，我哋会发觉咧，祈祷咧其实唔系我哋希望喺神当中攞到啲咩嘢。
Prayer is about getting to know God, discovering His will, and aligning our character according to His will.
其实祈祷咧系更加系令到我哋去认识神，亦都系让我哋咧更加明白佢嘅旨意，同埋咧同神保持一致嘅。
So God has called us to be a praying church. We need to persevere in prayer.
当神呢要求我哋成为一间祷告嘅教会，我哋坚持祷告要几耐呢？
Jesus asked his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth?"
耶稣问佢啲门徒啊，佢话人子来嘅时候，遇得见世上有信德、有信心嘅人有冇呢？
If we continue to persevere in prayer.Then when Jesus comes, He will indeed find faith on earth.
如果我哋持续不断咁样去祈祷嘅时候，当主耶稣再嚟嘅时候，佢就会见到我哋就系有信心嘅人。
To persevere in prayer is our responsibility. To answer the prayer is God's responsibility.
持续不断嘅祷告系我哋嘅责任，而回答我哋嘅祈祷呢个系神所做嘅事。
And if we persevere in prayer, God will change us to become more like Jesus.
如果我哋可以坚持不断咁样去祈祷，神就会藉着呢个咁嘅祈祷，让我哋嘅生命得着更新同改变。
So once a month, we practice praying, And we're going to pray up here together. And I want you to pray with someone, two by two. And if you're a husband and wife, split up. Pray with someone else. And if you came with someone, don't pray with them. Pray with someone new. Okay? So get up, pair up with someone. And the elders, please make sure everyone has a partner. And we pray. And then when I say amen, we stop.
我哋而家咧就会咧两个人两个人一组咁样咧去祈祷，咁然后咧，我哋尽量去揾一啲我哋唔系净系同佢一齐祈祷嘅人，我哋一齐祈祷之后咧，当主任牧师佢讲话啊，我哋讲阿门嘅时候咧，咁我哋就完成咗，我哋一齐学习祈祷。Okay,
make sure you're paired up.
大家咧要两个人两个人一组咁样啊。Yes,
please.
系啦。
All right, pray together.
In Jesus' name, amen.